What's going on, everybody? Kwaku here with another video. Today, a little different kind of video. Today, I actually want to use this as an opportunity to do update, I believe it's 3.0. With this update 3.0, a few things I want to kind of do off the cuff. It is to celebrate 1,000 subscribers. That is amazing, and I'll get to that in a second. It's to also celebrate what happens next on the channel, such as what kind of videos are going to come soon, and you know, as we get to the next milestone, which I think is a 2500, I believe, what happens after that, things like that, and just to check in with you guys as well. So right off the bat, 1,000 subscribers. I started this channel, at least I restarted this channel end of April last year. And I had like maybe 11 subs, or maybe even less. Maybe I had like 7 subs. Made videos prior to that, but some crazy things happened. My dad passed away in 2019, and COVID happened in 2020. And so in the middle of the lockdown is when I restarted the channel, because there was nothing else to do. And I was looking on YouTube, and I was seeing how nobody covers Microsoft apps, even though the apps aren't much, but I like to see obviously what developers are making for every platform. You may not see it on the channel, but I still look at what developers are making on Android and iOS as well. So I'll probably start bringing those in too, kind of bringing in app reviews from across all ecosystems in, but I'll still focus mainly on Microsoft stuff, mainly around Windows. So 1,000 subscribers hit. It was the most random and insane thing that I've probably seen from myself in a long time. It was so random because April last year, I was like less than 2 hands worth of subs. And now I can't even have the amount of hands. In fact, nobody in my street can even put up the amount of hands that can even have the amount of subs I have now. I think we're up to like 1027 or something like that now, which is amazing. All with no trendy hardware like an iPhone, talking about iPhone stuff or the latest phone this or the latest phone that. These subs are here because of just my passion. It's not because I'm trying to be trendy or anything like that. They're just natural subs, and that's one thing that makes it very special for me. Now, with that too, I wanted to just kind of inject this other thing. I've had some ideas on where this can go next, and I've had some ideas all around the place. So right here, I have Microsoft Lumia. I don't know which one it was. This might be 640, you know, I'm not sure. Someone will tell me which one this is, and I'm gonna look, make sure it's there. And then right here, it's kind of dirty, and let me make sure I'm in frame. Right here, if I'm there, yep. Right here is a Microsoft Kin 2 from Verizon. It works, it turns on and everything. Unfortunately, I can't make calls because I don't have Verizon. Windows Phone Verizon, Sharp. This was made by Sharp. And then another thing I have here is a BlackBerry Classic, which was one of the last BlackBerries to release. It has a touchscreen and everything. And what I'm saying with those things is, I kind of want to look back at some of the apps from the past and see how, you know, developing has changed over the years. Now, I'm not a developer, I'm a designer. So I do graphic design, I do photography, I don't do videography, but I'm getting into it. And so I look at all these things from a designer standpoint, in terms of UI design, UX design. I build computers. Obviously, this computer next to you guys here is the one that I made myself. I bought all the parts and I assembled it myself. So that will be coming soon, the next computer. I call it Behemoth 1.0, but Behemoth 2.0 will be coming. Maybe I'll build it live, who knows. But going back, just kind of rewinding, I just want to say thank you to everybody who really kind of gave me tips and tricks. I know when we get on the internet, people tend to want to feel like they're in control, and they kind of want to inject their agenda into everybody who looks like they're trying to do something, which is why I don't listen to like half of the feedback that, or more than half the feedback that I get on the channel. But I do see it, don't get me wrong. And so that's why you've noticed a lot of things have changed over the while. Another thing that has happened to me in a while is this right here. This is from Microsoft. This is from Windows. This is the Windows Insider MVP thing for 2021. I received that award probably back in February. I got notified of it back in January. So I've been a Windows Insider MVP ever since. And all of this wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for you guys kind of really looking at my channel and really just kind of, I know I see the amount of like how long people watch things, but I know as well a lot of people put it on the side and like watch my channel or listen to my channel while they program or whatever they do. So that's really dope. Thank you so much. And I just wanted to also just dedicate it to my dad, because if it wasn't for him and introducing me into tech and building, working on his government computer that he brought home, his desktop, it's like a compact pavilion desktop, switching out the DVD drive or switching out a floppy disk drive to a DVD drive and things like that. If I didn't see him doing those things and me wanting to touch them, I wouldn't be doing this channel right now. I wouldn't have built my own computer or anything. So I just want to say thank you all for that. So the next milestone that I have for myself is 2,500. Now that could come soon, that could come later, who knows, I don't really care, but it's a good milestone for me to want to hit. And between now and that milestone, which is like 1,500 or so, a few things I want to do. Like I showed you guys, I want to look at RetroTech, kind of like MKBHD, how he looked at RetroTech, such as the Kin 2, kind of look back on the story of the Kin line, why they only lasted like 2 months. Kind of, I want to look back at Windows Phone, which is this right here. I don't know if it's even charged or not. Yep, it's charged. Look back at Windows Phone. I have the Lumia 1020 as well. It doesn't work, it's bricked, but I can get another one. Look back at Windows Phone and what people like so much about it. That was my first smartphone, ironically. Just look back at those things and see how they worked. And then I have some futuristic projects that I'm working on. So a futuristic thing that I'm working towards is actually grabbing HoloLens 2. That should be coming in the next couple months. Two other things that I have, I'm looking for this thing called, the Next Mind. Basically, it's a brain interface. You just clip it to your hat or the band that comes with it, and it sits at the back of your head right here. And basically what it allows you to do is essentially, I'm looking at the viewfinder right here, that's why I'm not looking at you guys. And if there are buttons here that I can press, but with that Next Mind, I could literally look at some button there and I could think about it as long as software supports it. And I could engage with the screen and the elements on my screen without even touching it. I just have to think about it. Not even looking at it, just think about it. It's just connected to a hat, touches your rear cortex. I forgot what it's called, visual cortex, I believe. And it basically just works. And then another thing that I'm looking towards is the Intel RealSense 3D cameras, similar to the Kinect cameras. And basically what those allow you to do is a number of things. One of the big things that I'll be showcasing is the ability to touch your screen or use your screen like a touch screen without actually touching your screen. So your fingers will be like this. Imagine this is the screen. Your fingers will be like this close to the screen and it'll function like a touch screen. It'll know about your swiping and all that stuff. Apparently it works really well. You can use it for digital signage. I'll probably be getting my hands on one of those as well and showcasing that, how to set it up, how it works, interacting with Windows and apps elements without even touching them, but it works as a touch screen. Hopefully it works well. So there's that as well. There's a number of things that I'm looking towards. And then obviously Behemoth 2.0, which is what I call my computer, Behemoth 1.0, this one. That one will be coming soon. The specs are gonna be insane. 128 gigs of RAM. Hopefully I can get my hands on a 3090 or 3080. Ryzen 5950X or 5800X. 5900 would be perfect, but can't find those. Just a bunch of things with that around that space. And then there'll be more app reviews coming as usual, just to fill in the blanks, some news in the middle of that. But those are some of the big things that I'm looking towards. And then obviously, if we do get Surface Duo 2 at the end of the year, definitely you're gonna see me cover that thing. I'm gonna try to cover it more extensively than I did with the original one, where I did like 5 videos for it. That will come too. And then I'll probably have some in-store demos of Surface Pro 8 when it does come at the end of the year, hopefully. So there's a lot of things coming, and yeah, I just wanted you guys to stay tuned, and also I just wanted to say thank you once again for all the support, all the suggestions and support so that I can have ideas to do for the channel, because sometimes it is hard, like today it's kind of hard to do that, because there's not much that's out there right now. I do have some app reviews coming down the road, but yeah, My name is Kwaku Asafu Ajay, and yeah, I am originally from Ghana, in the US, obviously, and hope you guys enjoy this video. It's a little long one. It's kind of, it doesn't have a direct topic, but hope you guys enjoy the video and enjoy your week. Stay tuned for more videos from this channel or my channel, Next Windows, and I'll catch you guys later.